Thank you. So yesterday the volcanic eruption occurred, resulting in a tsunami wave in Tonga and surrounding areas. So we're now on alert in relation to the risk of a tsunami coming to the state of New South Wales, to our eastern shores. So as a result, the Bureau of Meteorology have issued a tsunami warning, and the SES have acted on that. We're working very closely with surf lifesaving and local government areas in relation to the safety of our community along the coastal areas. So Lord Howe Island is our most eastern point of New South Wales, and there have been recorded increases in the river, in the water levels of 1.1 metre. And we're watching now and getting advice from the Bureau in relation to what is expected on the coast, the east coast of New South Wales. As a result, the beaches have been closed today, and I know a lot of people will be disappointed that it's going to be a very humid day, and the Australian way is to get down to the beach. But to protect this community, the beaches are closed, and Surf Life Saving have removed the flags, and we're making sure that people don't go down into the water. So already today we've had a rescue for Surf Life Saving of a rock fisherman who had to be rescued. Again, please don't go down to the beaches. Please don't go rock fishing where you are placing yourself at danger, and therefore placing the volunteers and emergency service rescuers in danger as well. So what is happening today is the Bureau of Meteorology in about half an hour will do another update, but we're expected that the beaches will be closed for the next 6 hours, because it's important that we watch the height of the oceans and make sure that people aren't in the water and aren't at risk of injury or death as a result of any tsunami that may hit our shores. So it's important, as I say, not to go down to the beach, but it's also important to understand not to go down and look at the tsunami. So in past tsunami warnings, we've had people get in their vehicles and go down to the beach. That is exactly the wrong thing to do. We want to make sure that whoever is in the nearby vicinity, we can evacuate people safely, we can have the roads as clear as possible, and we can make sure people are safe. Because once that wave, if it does come, is coming, it's very vital and very urgent to get people away from the areas. So I'd encourage all members of the community not to go out boating, not to go to the beaches, not to go to rock fishing places and put themselves in danger. If they are already out on boats, stay away from the shore if they can, if they can't come back into safety. Please ensure that you keep up to date with the warnings that are put out both by the Bureau of Meteorology, and that's who we're taking our advice from, the experts, the SES websites and information, and the radio and communication media channels as well that put out important information. It's important also to remember that not all beaches are patrolled by Surf Life Saving. So again, just use common sense and don't go down to the beach areas. Surf Life Savers are working with SES volunteers and councils to make sure people aren't putting themselves in danger. Please follow their directions, because it is for your safety. It's to make sure that you are safe and do the right thing. So just be aware of the surroundings for wherever you are, and stay away from those beaches today. Thank you.
How likely is it that a tsunami will hit the coast of New South Wales?
Well, based on the advice, there's obviously elements of what a tsunami is, and so that's what we rely on the Bureau of Meteorology to do their modelling in relation to this. So, you know, we're very concerned, because once it hits Lord Howe Island, and particularly at the height of 1.1, we're anticipating that we'll come onto the shores of New South Wales. So we're working, we have the Bureau embedded in the New South Wales SES headquarters to give us advice, both, you know, in relation to their forecast. So we take all the measures that we can based on their advice.
Are you mobilising?
We have a unit on Lord Howe Island already. We have evacuated 50 people to higher ground from low-lying areas in Lord Howe Island, and that was done during the night. And they're not allowed to go back into those areas until it's declared safe by the Bureau again. And it does take some time. They have to keep watching those water levels.
Thank you.